elements. In the previous class we discussed about the oxides of carbon. We also discussed about the acid rains. Now we will be discussing the particulate pollutants. Particulate pollutants here. What do you mean by particulate pollutants? They are the minute solid particles or liquid droplets in air. They are the minute solid or liquid droplets in air, which are present in the emissions of vehicle, smoke particles from fires, dust particles, and ash from industries. So this, what do you mean by this particulate pollutants? They are the minute solid or liquid droplets in air, which are emitted from the vehicles or emissions of vehicles or smoke from vehicles, smoke particles from fire, dust particles and ash from industries. This particulates in the atmosphere can be viable. They are of two types, viable and non-viable. Viable and non-viable. So the particulates in the viable particulates are bacteria, fungi, molds, algae, etc. They are the minute living organisms that are dispersed in the atmosphere. Human beings are allergic to some of the fungi found in air, and you know they also cause plant diseases. They can also cause plant diseases. So these viable particulates are nothing but microorganisms which cause disease in both plants as well as in animals. Now coming to non-viable particulates, they may be classified according to their nature and size as follows. One by one we will be discussing. First one is smoke particulates. Smoke particulates. Here non-viable particulates may be classified according to their nature and size as follows. One is smoke particulates, which is consisting of solid or mixture of solid and liquid particles. The smoke can be solid particles or mixture of or a combination of solid and liquid particles that is formed during combustion of organic matter. When you burn plant and animal products, this smoke particles are released into the atmosphere. For example, you see here, cigarette smoke. Smoke from burning of fossil fuels like coal and petrol. Garbage. When you burn garbage, dry leaves releases smoke into the atmosphere. They release smoke into the atmosphere. So here, we are discussing about particulate pollutants. What do you mean by particulate pollutants? The particulate pollutants are minute, solid or liquid droplets in air, which are released by, which are released from the vehicles, or which are released from the fire, or dust particles and ash from industries. Then these particulates are of two types, viable and non-viable. Viable particulates are nothing but microorganisms. Non-viable, for example, we discuss now, smoke particulates. Smoke particulates, we will be continuing our discussion. Please take a screenshot. There is non-viable particulates. We discussed smoke. Now we will be discussing dust, which is composed of fine solid particles. This dust is composed of fine solid particles that are produced during crushing, grinding of some solid material. When solid materials are crushed, grinded, then dust is released into the atmosphere. Apart from that, sand from sand blasting, sawdust from woodworks, you know, from when you cut the wood in order to make some furniture, you get some sawdust. Sawdust from woodworks. Pulverized coal, where the coal is finely grinded into fine powder. Cement and the fly ash from factories. Dust storms, They are examples of particulate emissions. They are examples of particulate emissions. You see here, the dust is composed of fine solid particles produced during crushing, grinding of solid materials. Sand from sand blasting, in the extraction of sand, fine particles of sand is released into the atmosphere. Sawdust from woodworks, pulverized coal, cement and fly ash from factories, dust storms, they are examples of particulate emissions. They are examples of what? Particulate emissions. Now coming to the mist. What do you mean by mist? Tiny water droplets suspended in air is called mist. Tiny water droplets in air. Water droplets in air is called what? Mist. This mist is produced by particles of spray liquids and by condensation of vapors in air. What do you mean by condensation? Where gas is converted to liquid. By condensation of vapors in air, mist is formed. For example, here, sulfuric acid mist and herbicides and insecticides that miss their targets and travel through air and form mist. So along with these tiny droplets, the what is mist? Fine water droplets in air, or water droplets in air is called a mist. Sulfuric acid also form mist, and the herbicides and insecticides that miss their targets and they reach the air and form mist and form a mist. And you know these fumes, white dense fumes or colored dense fumes, they are generally obtained by condensation of vapors during sublimation. What do you mean by sublimation? Where solid is directly converted to gas. Distillation. You know distillation. This technique is generally followed when two liquids are miscible with each other. Boiling and several chemical reactions. Hence, why the fumes are released into the atmosphere. Generally, organic solvents, metals and metallic oxides form fume particles. For example, you take any metal oxide, zinc oxide, and heat it, you can see some fumes escaping into the atmosphere. Organic solvents, which would be benzene or ether or something, they form few particles of fume, and airborne particles, the particles that are airborne, that is such as the dust, fumes, mist, they are dangerous to human health. Particulate pollutants bigger than 5 microns, they are likely to accumulate or lodge in the nasal passage. They deposit in the nasal passage or they accumulate in the nasal passage. Where this is the nasal passage. Whereas the particles of about 10 micron enter into lungs directly. They enter into lungs very easily. You see here, what is dust? Dust is nothing but which is composed of fine solid particles produced during crushing, grinding of solid materials. Sand from sand blasting, sawdust from woodworks, pulverized coal, cement and fly ash industries or factories, dust storms, they are examples of particulate emissions. And now coming to mist, what is mist? Suspension of water droplets in air is nothing but what? Mist. They are produced by particles of spray liquids. Condensation of vapors in air, sulfuric acid mist, herbicides and insecticides miss their targets, travel through air and form mist. And fumes, they are generally obtained during condensation of vapors during sublimation, distillation, boiling and several chemical reactions. Generally, organic solvents, metals and metallic oxides form fume particles. Airborne particles such as dust, fumes, mist, etc. They are dangerous to human health. Particulate pollutants bigger than 5 microns are likely to lodge in the nasal passage, whereas particles of about 10 microns enter into the lungs very easily. That is about non-viable particulates. We will be continuing our discussion. Please take a screenshot. Blended petrol is used to be the primary source of airborne lead emission in Indian cities. The release of harmful metal, that is the lead, into air is because of using leaded petrol. That is, a tetraethyl lead is added to the petrol. Generally, we say Indian oil. It is the primary source of airborne lead emission in Indian cities. Airborne lead emission in Indian cities. And this problem has now been overcome by using unleaded petrol. Unleaded petrol in most of the cities in India. What is this harmful effect of lead? Lead is interfering with the development and maturation of red blood cells. It showed its effect on red blood cells, where the development and maturity of red blood cells are affected. You see, development and maturation of red blood cells, they are affected. And now coming to another topic, that is the smog. The word smog is derived from smoke plus fog. What is fog? Presence of water droplets in air. Combination of smoke plus fog will give you smog. Common examples of air pollution. It is a common example of air pollution that occurs in many cities throughout the world. So it is one of the most pollution, common air pollution that occurs in most of the cities throughout the world. There are two types of smog. One is a classical smog, the other one is a photochemical smog. Photochemical smog. What is this classical smog? It occurs in cool and humid climate, where the climate is very cool and humid. It is a mixture of smoke, fog, and sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide. So this, due to presence of the sulfur dioxide, fog, smoke, chemically it is a reducing mixture. Chemically it is a reducing mixture, and it is also called reducing smog. It is also called what? Reducing smog. Please see here. Leaded petrol used to be the primary source of airborne lead emission in Indian cities. It is one of the primary source of airborne lead emission of a release of lead into the air. This problem is now overcome by using unleaded petrol in most of the cities in India. Lead interferes with the development and maturation of red blood cells. It interferes with the development and the maturation of red blood cells. Now, smog, the word smog is derived from smoke plus fog. It is the most common example of air pollution that is observed in many cities throughout the world. It is of two types, classical smog and chemical smog. Classical smog is known as reducing smog because it is containing, chemically it is a reducing, it is containing reducing agents, reducing smog. Photochemical smog, the name itself is indicating that it occurs in warm, dry and sunny climate. Photo means light. The main components of the photochemical smog result from the action of sunlight on unsaturated hydrocarbons and nitrogen oxides. You know what are unsaturated hydrocarbons? Compounds of carbon containing double bond and triple bond. They are called unsaturated hydrocarbons, that is alkenes and alkynes. By the action of sunlight on unsaturated hydrocarbons and oxides of nitrogen produced by automobiles and factories, photochemical smog has high concentration of oxidizing agents, therefore called oxidizing smog. Oxidizing smog. Here, photochemical smog is generally produced. It is the result of action of sunlight on unsaturated hydrocarbons and nitrogen oxides. Nitrogen oxide. Photochemical smog has high concentration of oxidizing agents and is therefore called oxidizing smog. It is therefore called what? Oxidizing smog. Please take a screenshot. We will be continuing our discussion. Now we will be discussing formation of photochemical smog. Formation of photochemical smog. By burning fossil fuels like coal and petroleum, unburnt hydrocarbons and nitric oxide is released into the environment. When their levels reach maximum, or when they reach to higher concentration, by the action of sunlight, nitric oxide is converted to nitrogen dioxide. Nitrogen dioxide. This nitrogen dioxide, that is NO2, further gets converted to nitric oxide and free oxygen atom by absorbing the energy from the sunlight. That is the H nu. Energy carried by photon is E is equal to H nu. H is Planck's constant, nu is frequency. All this is not necessary. This is the energy from the sunlight. E is equal to H nu. H nu is written here. Nitrogen dioxide absorbs energy from sunlight, gets converted to nitric oxide, NO, and free oxygen atom. Please remember here, it is an oxygen atom, not molecule. This oxygen atom is very reactive. It combines with another molecule of oxygen to give ozone. To give ozone. Nitrogen dioxide, by absorbing the energy from sunlight, gets converted to nitric oxide plus free oxygen atom. This free oxygen atom is very reactive. It reacts with oxygen, gets converted to ozone. This ozone further reacts with nitric oxide, gets converted to nitrogen dioxide, NO2, and oxygen. NO2 is a reddish brown gas and is also responsible for the formation of a red haze. We already discussed. It is generally observed in polluted environment and congested places where there is a lot of traffic. Lot of traffic. You can observe this red haze in polluted environment. And this nitrogen dioxide and ozone, they are strong oxidizing agents. They react with unburnt hydrocarbons. For example, you see this ozone, O3 reacts with unburnt hydrocarbon, that is methane, to give HCH double bond O, or you can write it like this, CH2O, that is nothing but formaldehyde. Formaldehyde. Acrolein, CH2 double bond, CH double bond, acrolein is, and peroxyacetyl nitrate, abbreviated as PAN, P-A-N, peroxyacetyl nitrite. Peroxyacetyl nitrite. Okay? Effects of photochemical smog.
this, you know, in photochemical smog, which is formed due to ozone, nitric oxide, pond and formaldehyde. This ozone and pond, that is peroxide acetyl nitrite, they are powerful eye irritants. Powerful eye irritants. Ozone and nitric oxide irritate the throat or throat, nose, and their high concentration causes headache, chest pain, dryness of throat, cough, breathing problems. And photochemical smog causes cracking of rubber and damage to plant life, and it also causes corrosion of metals, stones, rubber and painted surfaces. You see here, photochemical smog is formed by fossil fuels and burning fossil fuels, unburnt hydrocarbons and nitric oxides or oxides of nitrogen are released into the environment. Nitric oxide, by the action of sunlight, gets converted to nitrogen dioxide. This nitrogen dioxide, by absorbing the energy present in sunlight, is further converted to nitric oxide and free oxygen atom. This free oxygen atom is more reactive, it combines with another oxygen molecule to give ozone. This ozone is a strong oxidizing agent. It reacts with nitric oxide to give nitrogen dioxide, which is a reddish brown gas, plus oxygen. This ozone further reacts, it is also reacting with methane, that is, which is unburnt hydrocarbon, to give formaldehyde, acrolein, and peroxyacetyl nitrite. And what are the effects of photochemical smog? This ozone and peroxyacetyl nitrate, they are powerful eye irritants. Ozone and nitric oxide, they irritate the throat, nose, and their high concentration causes headache, chest pain, dryness of throat or throat, cough, breathing problems, cracking of rubber, and damage to plant life, corrosion of metals, stones, rubber, and painted surfaces. Please take a screenshot. We will be continuing our discussion. Now we will be discussing how can photochemical smog be controlled. This is very important. If we control primary precursors, such as nitrogen dioxide and hydrocarbons, ultimately we can control this ozone and peroxyacetyl nitrate. That is the secondary precursors such as ozone and PAN will be reduced. It is because of primary precursors we are getting this ozone and PAN. So how to control this? By using catalytic converters in automobiles, they prevent the release of nitrogen oxides and hydrocarbons into the atmosphere. And there are also plants which can metabolize nitrogen oxides, which can absorb this nitrogen oxide. What are these plants? Pinus, Juniperus, Persis, Pyrus, Vitis. They can metabolize nitrogen. You see here, how can photochemical smog be controlled? If we control nitrogen dioxide and hydrocarbons, we can control the production of, or we can control the formation of ozone and PAN. How to control this nitrogen dioxide and hydrocarbons? If we use catalytic converters in automobiles, we can control the release of nitrogen dioxide and hydrocarbons. They prevent the release of nitrogen oxide and hydrocarbons to the atmosphere. Who are they? Catalytic converters that are usually in automobiles. Apart from this, there are also plants like Pinus, Juniperus, Persis, Pyrus, Vitis. They can metabolize nitrogen oxides. That is the end of particulate pollutants. Please take a screenshot. It will be